All right, today we have a fun video. We're going to be taking a look at characters who should be legendary. Now, I know that not every legendary character in the game is good, so it really doesn't matter if a character is gold or legendary or even in some cases silver. But at the end of the day, if I was making the game, because I have common sense, I would definitely make all the legendary characters the best characters in the game. And so these characters are definitely good enough, in my opinion, to be legendary characters. With that being said, I just want to say thank you guys for the support. We've been absolutely crushing it recently. The like to dislike ratios are off the charts. The watch time on every single video is absolutely insane. The views are through the roof. I can't say thank you enough. I really do appreciate it. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Stay safe and stay clean. Let's start the video. Starting off our list is going to be Atlantean Armored Aquaman. AAA batteries, one of my favorite characters in the entire game. This character definitely deserves to be a legendary, and I'm not saying that just because I'm biased towards this character. So, the main reason why I think Atlantean Armored Aquaman should definitely be a legendary is because his passive and his special abilities work really, really well together. His passive heals up the entire team whenever he uses one of his special abilities, and his special 1 has armor pierce, and his special 2 has dot damage and power drain, and his special 3 does a decent amount of damage. But hold up, let's back it up a little bit. Let's go back to his special 2. His special 2 does dot damage, it does power drain, it's a really big hazard, so it's really easy to get your opponents in there, and it's going to be healing up the entire team, including Atlantean Armored Aquaman himself. And the healing of his passive is about 5,000. So it's definitely not a little bit. It's going to be helping out your team a lot. And on top of that, you're going to be using your special ability, which is going to be doing damage to the opponent. But on top of that, with the power drain, you're going to be disabling your opponents from using their special abilities, which is going to help out your entire team as well. One more thing I want to say about Atlantean Armored Aquaman, and pretty much every other character on this list, is that if these characters were turned into legendaries, they would have more health and more attack, because their stats would be increased. Imagine Atlantean Armored Aquaman with an entropy, with his passive, with his special 2, and about 100,000 health. That would be absolutely badass. Moving on to number 4 is going to be Multiverse Armored Supergirl. Multiverse Armored Supergirl has a lot of different things going on for her, but the main reason why I think she should be a legendary is because of her special 1. Her special 1 inflicts burning, and what burning does is it cuts the opponent's defense in half, and she also makes it so that the opponent cannot resist any critical attack hits from the multiverse team. This special ability also does dot damage, which means that even if the opponent has a reflective shield, they're not going to be able to block it. This special ability is very, very unique, because your opponent is not going to be able to resist any critical attack hits, so this is going to be really useful in raids and in arena to be doing a lot of damage. Another really cool thing about Multiverse Armored Supergirl is, just like other legendary characters, Multiverse Armored Supergirl isn't just focused on doing a lot of damage. Her special 2 is very defensive, literally, because it gives the entire multiverse team crit immunity and it gives them defense. And finally, for her special 3, it will be doing extra damage towards opponents that are burning. It gives the entire team extra critical attack chance and critical attack damage, and it makes the multiverse team immune to reflective shields for a certain amount of time. If we go look at Multiverse Armored Supergirl's passives, her passive 1 and her passive 2, it's not really that great, to be honest. It's a cool bonus, but whatever. Her main passive is her passive 3. Her main passive is her passive 3, and this one is really, really good. So what it does is, whenever you have one of your multiverse teammates tagged in, and then you tag in Multiverse Armored Supergirl, she will land an unblockable attack that will interrupt the opponent. And if she interrupts a special ability from the opponent, you gain 4 power bars. This is honestly really fun to use no matter what game mode you're playing. Whether it be raids or arena, your opponent is going to be doing special abilities all day, so the fact that you can interrupt them and gain power bars and use your own special abilities is really, really satisfying. Moving on to number 3 is going to be Batman Ninja Catwoman. So there's 2 main reasons why Batman Ninja Catwoman should be a legendary. It's because of her immortal passive and because of her special 2. Batman Ninja Catwoman's immortal passive makes herself and her Batman Ninja teammates unkillable whenever they reach 15% of their health. So this passive is really great, but it would be really trash if we didn't have any sort of healing effects on the Batman Ninja team. And fortunately, or unfortunately if you're fighting this team, every single main character of the Batman Ninja team does have healing. Robin has healing. Gorilla Grodd has healing. And Batman Ninja Catwoman also has healing on her special too. And Batman Ninja Catwoman's special too is very, very devastating for the opponent, especially if you're playing in arena, because this dot damage lasts for a very, very long time. And 200% of that dot damage dealt is going to be healing up Batman Ninja Catwoman. And because this dot damage is going to be applied for such a long time, you're going to be healing up for a very long time as well. This is really overpowered because that immortal passive is going to keep on triggering every single time that you heal yourself up. So even if you're bad at the game, you should never die. I also want to say that Batman Ninja Catwoman's passive 3 is really fun, but there is just one small problem that I have with it. So what it does is whenever you block a special ability from the opponent, you're going to gain some power bars according to how much that special ability cost for yourself. But the thing is that if you block it with Batman Ninja Catwoman, she's going to trigger her special 3 for free. I know that sounds like a really good thing, but the problem is that if you don't want to do your special 3 at that specific time, you can ruin your combo meter or worst. If you wanted to use your special 2 at that specific time, but now your special 3 is being activated and you're really low health, you might get knocked out. I do like the idea of being able to get some power bars from blocking your opponent's special abilities, but doing free special 3s all the time is definitely going to get in your way. Moving on to number 2 is going to be Heartbreaker Harley Quinn. This was honestly kind of a tie between Last Laugh Joker and Heartbreaker Harley Quinn, but the main reason why I put Heartbreaker Harley Quinn is because this team, the League of Anarchy team, or any variation of having Heartbreaker Harley Quinn and Last Laugh Joker with Entangling Poison Ivy is going to be doing a lot of basic attack damage. And Heartbreaker Harley Quinn has a 3-hit fast attack, and that is very, very useful to be doing more damage on your basic attack hits. So the main reason why this character is coming on the list is pretty obvious. This character does a lot of basic attack damage. As a matter of fact, in certain areas of raids, she is the best damage dealer in the entire game. So there's 3 different parts to the Heartbreaker Harley Quinn team. There's going to be Arkham Knight Batman's special 2, which is going to be able to stun any opponent, including raids. There's Heartbreaker Harley Quinn's passive 3, which is going to give her more damage whenever the opponent is stunned. And then there's Entangling Poison Ivy's passive that gives all League of Anarchy characters dot damage on their basic attack hits. Before I move on, I just want to say something. I know some people are going to say that Entangling Poison Ivy should be the legendary character for this team, since she helps out both Last Laugh Joker and Heartbreaker Harley Quinn, but unfortunately in raids and solo raids, this really doesn't matter because I'm only going to be able to use her with one team. And also, for a lot of people, their damage dealer is the best part of their team, so I'm going to go ahead and put Heartbreaker Harley Quinn as the legendary character. But if you wanted to say that Entangling Poison Ivy should be the legendary character, I'm not going to argue with that because she's a really good support for Heartbreaker Harley Quinn to be doing a lot of damage. But with that being said, let's move on to number 1, which is going to be King of Atlantis Aquaman. First of all, King of Atlantis Aquaman has been at number 1 spot for my top 5s many different times, easily like 5 or 6 times. So that already tells you how good this character is. And like I said in the last ranking when this guy came in at number 1, I don't really have to explain too much about this character because everybody knows who he is. Even if you just started playing the game yesterday, you have heard of King of Atlantis Aquaman. So what makes this character really great is his special 3. His special 3 takes away percentages of health of the opponent, and this also works in raids and solo raids, which means that even if you just got this character, you're still going to be doing a lot of damage. And his passive 1 makes it so that King of Atlantis Aquaman's attack can go up to 600%. Whenever you use your special abilities. His special 1 gives him 50% more attack, and his special 2 and his special 3 gives him 100% more attack. And for his passive 2, whenever King of Atlantis Aquaman uses his super move, it will disable the opponent's super move for 1 minute, and it will also power drain them by 3 power bars. And finally, for his passive 3, whenever King of Atlantis Aquaman dies, he comes back to life according to how many power bars he has. Every single power bar is 10% of his health. This passive is definitely a really great bonus for this character. King of Atlantis Aquaman is mainly going to be focusing on doing damage, and the fact that this passive brings him back to life makes it a little bit easier to use this character because you don't have to worry about his health all the time. Another really great thing about King of Atlantis Aquaman is that his special 3 can connect with his basic attack hits, so once you use your special 3, you could start doing your basic attack hits right away. And because King of Atlantis Aquaman is going to have increased attack with his passive 1, his basic attack hits are going to be doing a lot of damage. So the fact that you can connect after a special Special 3 helps you do a little bit more damage. The only bad thing about King of Atlantis Aquaman is that he has a skin in Fortnite. Anyways, guys, that's pretty much it. I just want to say that it really doesn't matter if a character's gold or legendary in this game. It's made a little bit weird because you would expect legendary characters to be the best type of characters in this game, but some of them just really, really suck. I know that some of them are really good for raids and solo raids, but legendary characters are really hard to get, so you would expect them to be really good in any game mode, but that's just not the case. Also, keep in mind, this video is just for fun. I don't actually want these characters to be legendary, and the main reason why is because it would be a lot harder to get these characters. It's just that if I was making a game and I had common sense, which I do, I would make these characters legendary because they're really, really good. Anyways, guys, with that being said, I hope you guys have a nice day. Stay safe and stay clean, and I'll see you guys later.